Welcome everybody. So today I am going to explain you one assignment on bubble sorting. We are going to implement this assignment by using assembly language. So first of all, let's try to clear what is input and output for this assignment. So in order to implement this assignment, first of all, you have to create one text file. So in this case, suppose I have created 1.txt text file. Now, what should be the content of this text file? So this text file should contain the numbers on which you want to apply the sorting. So let's assume that this 1.txt file contains the numbers like 3, then 1, then 4, then 8. So you can take as many number as you want, but this number should be a single digit number. So first of all, we will implement this assignment on single digit, and then you can try for multi digit numbers. So this will be the input to your assignment. Okay, this will be input to your assembly language program. Input is clear to you? So input to this assignment is the numbers which you have stored in this 1.txt file. So your assembly language program should read this number, and then it should sort this number, and after sorting, what is expected? The numbers which you are getting should be again copied, again written in this 1.txt file. Okay, so these were our unsorted number. So what you have to do, you have to sort them, and then again you have to write those sorted numbers again back in the same file. So one, so if I sort that sequence, then I will get number like 1, then 3, then 4, and then 8. So after execution of your assembly language program, this should be the content of your 1.txt file. It should contain unsorted number followed by sorted number. So input and output is clear to you? Yes? I hope it is clear. Now, let's try to understand algorithm to implement this particular program. So here, what should be the step number one? So here, step number one will be open file. Which file? That 1.txt file. Okay. We want to apply sorting on the numbers, and those numbers are stored in which file? In 1.txt file. So first of all, what you have to do? You have to open that 1.txt file. So how we can open this file? So here you can use two approach. Either you can use C functions or you can use system call. So some students are familiar with the C functions. They can continue this assignment with those C function. And some students are familiar with system call. They can go with system call. So I will explain this assignment by using system call. So here for opening file, what you have to do? You have to use file open system call. Already you are familiar with what is system call. You have used read system call, you have used write system call. So we'll not go into the details of this system call. Okay, so now let's try to understand the parameters of file open system call. Are you getting what we are discussing? What is our aim? What is our aim? Our aim is to open text file. Which text file? 1.txt. For opening that file, we are going to use file open system call. So parameters of file open system call are, so first parameter is function number. As we have seen that in case of read system call, write system call, first parameter is also a function number. So what was function number of read system call? Yes, it was 0. For write system call, it was 1. And for file open system call, it is 2. Okay, then second parameter is file path. If I want to open some file, I will require path of that file. Then third parameter is mode in which that file is to be open. So for opening file, we are going to use this particular value, 402h. Okay, so here this first 4 indicate that I want to open file in append mode. Okay, first 4 indicate that I want to open text file in append mode. So why I want to open that file in append mode? Yes, so this is our text file. What I am saying, we have to open this file in append mode. Why? Because in this file, at the end of execution of our program, we are expecting that 1.txt file should contain unsorted number and then followed by sorted number. Okay, so I want to append sorted number at the end of this 1.txt file. So that's why this 1.txt file, it should be open in append mode. So this first four, okay, so this first value in this particular mode indicate that I want to open that file in append mode. If I remove this four, then that file will not be open in append mode. Okay, whatever write operation I am going to perform on that append mode will remove, will destroy previous content of that file. Okay, so I want to keep previous content of that file as it is. So that's why here I should specify four. Then this two indicate that I want to open file in read as well as write mode. Okay, please try to understand this third digit. Okay, so this third digit here I have specified two. It can be zero, it can be one, and it can be two. Okay, please try to understand, I am talking about this third digit. So here if I take that third digit as zero, it indicates that I want to open file only in read mode. Okay, so here if I specify instead of 2, here if I take 0, what will happen? That file will be open in which mode? Read mode. Means we can perform only which operation? Read operation. Then if I specify that third digit as 1, then we can perform only write operation. And if I specify that third parameter as 2, then I can perform read as well as I can perform write operation. So you tell me in which mode this file should be open, 1.txt. Whether we want to perform read operation on this file? Yes, we want to perform read operation because we want to read this data. Whether we want to perform write operation? Yes, we also want to perform write operation. Okay, so that's why here I should specify this third digit as 2. Okay, and then next parameter is access permission. So access permission I will specify as 7770. So why this access permission, that also we have discussed. Otherwise I will make a separate lecture for explaining access permission. So access permission we have set to 7770, this is not 0, this is O. So this O indicate that this particular number is specified in octal number system. So this particular value for access permission indicate that we are giving read, write, execute access to all three types of user permitted by Linux. Okay, so which are those three types of users? So one is owner, second one is group user, and third one is other. Okay, so I will explain this access permission in detail in other lecture. I will make a separate lecture for this, otherwise this lecture will be very lengthy. So these are four parameters which are required for file open system call. Are you getting? So by using these four parameters we can open the file. So this file open system call will return one value in RX register. So which is that value? So see what I am saying. If this file open operation is successful, here what we are trying to do, we are trying to open a file. So this file open operation may be successful or it may not be successful. Can you tell me when this file will not be open successfully? Yes. So if the file which I am trying to open is not present in the system, whether this file open system call will be a successful? Yes. Whether this system call will be a successful? No. I can say that it will be, in that case it will be unsuccessful. So what I am saying, if file is open successfully, if file open system call is successful, then RAX register will contain positive value, and that positive value is called as file identifier, or it is also called as file handle. Okay, already we have seen what is file handle. So what is file handle? It is a unique number assigned to the file by operating system whenever some file is open or created successfully. Here we are trying to open file. If file is open successfully, operating system will assign unique number to that file, and that number is called as file handle. Okay, so content of RX register is clear to you? Okay, so if file is open successfully, RX register will contain file handle. And what you have to do, you have to store this file handle in some variable. So suppose I am using variable x. Okay, I am using this variable x for storing file handle, because we will require this file handle whenever we want to perform any operation on that text file later on. Okay, so later on we are interested in performing read operation on 1.txt file. We are interested in, we want to perform a write operation. We want to perform maybe a delete operation, close operation, any other operation. So whenever any operation is to be performed on some file, we will require file handle of that file. So when we are getting this file handle after opening file, so what you have to do after opening file, always you should store the file handle which you are getting in RX register. So you should store that file handle in some variable so that you can use that variable later on. Okay, so this is about return value of file open system call. Now if this operation is not successful, else, okay, if that operation is not successful, then RX register will contain negative value. Okay, so this is about step number one of this particular assignment. I hope now it is clear to you. Yes, it is very simple. So in step number one, what we are going to do, we are going to open that text file. Then step number two, let me explain step number two. So in step number two, what you have to do, you have to read that 1.txt file. This is second operation which you have to perform, or this is second step. So in second step, what we are going to do, we are going to perform read operation on 1.txt file. So when we perform read operation, then what happens, content of that file will be copied in the buffer. Okay, very simple. When we perform read operation on that some file, then what is going to happen actually, content of that file will be copied in buffer. So buffer means some part of memory can be considered as buffer. It is it can be considered as a variable. So in order to implement this step number two, again we are going to use file read system call. Okay, you are using this file read system call from first assignment, so we will not go into details, just we'll revise the parameters of file read system call. So which is first parameter? Yes, first parameter is function number. What is function number of read operation? Yes, it is zero. Okay, function number of read operation is zero. Then which is second parameter? Yes, second parameter is file handle. We have to specify file handle of the file on which we want to perform read operation. So we want to perform read operation on which file? 1.txt. So here file handle of 1.txt file is stored, it is stored in x, so that x will be a second parameter. Then third parameter, so in case of read operation, I told you that what is going to happen, content of file will be copied in some buffer, so we'll require buffer. So that buffer you have to specify here. Okay, and what is size of that buffer will be a fourth parameter. So this is file read system call. So this file read system call also return one value. It is also going to return one value in RX register. So which is that value? So if this operation is successful, which operation? Read operation. If read operation is successful, then RX register will contain one number which will indicate how many characters, number of characters transferred, number of characters transferred from file into buffer. Please try to understand which operation we are performing, read operation. If that operation is successful, then RX register will contain one number. That number will indicate how many characters are transferred from file into buffer. And if this operation is not successful, then RX register will contain some negative value, same as file open system call. Okay, so if system call is unsuccessful, then RX register will contain negative value. So this is step number two. I hope step number two is clear to you. So in step number two, what we are trying to do, we are trying to read content of text file. Now in this case, what are content of text file? This single digit number. So content of this text file will be copied in the buffer. So let's try to understand what will be the, so this is our step number two. So after execution of this step number two, can you tell me what will be the content of buffer? Provided that content of 1.txt file are like this. Yes, can you guess which will be the first element in the buffer? Yes, it will be a first character or first digit of 1.txt file. So which is first number in 1.txt file? It is 3. So in the buffer, whether I will get 3? No, I will not get 3. I will get ASCII value of 3. What is ASCII value of 3? It is 33H. Okay, so whatever data that is present in this file will be stored in memory in ASCII format. So when I read content of this file into the buffer, I will get ASCII value of all those character. Okay, so ASCII value of 3 is 33H. So this will be the first element of buffer. Then which will be the second element? Whether it will be 31H? No, it is not 31H. Please try to understand how I have stored these numbers in this file. How I am storing numbers in this file? First of all 3. After that, see what I am doing? I am pressing enter key. So enter key is also part of this file. Okay, so after 33H, I will have ASCII value of enter key. What is ASCII value of enter key? It is 0H. So suppose here I have stored second number as 2. So here next character will be 32H. After 2, again I am going to press enter key. So here again I will have ASCII value of enter key. And suppose the last character is 6. So what is ASCII value of 6? It is 36H. And please try to understand, by default last character of the file will be again 0AH. So this will be the content of my buffer. Okay, this will be the content of buffer after step number 2. Any doubt? Please try to understand content of buffer, then only you can apply bubble sorting on this buffer. Okay, you have to write code for bubble sorting in step number 3. Okay, so for writing that code, it is very essential that you must know what are content of the buffer or how numbers are stored in the buffer. So in this buffer, actually how many characters are coming? Total 6 characters. So whether our buffer contains 6 numbers? No, it does not contain 6 numbers. It actually contains only 3 numbers. Which are those 3 numbers? 33H, 32H and 36H. Whether the 0H is a number? No, these are ASCII values of enter key. Okay, so please try to understand content of buffer properly, then only you can implement step number 3. In step number 3, what you have to do? You have to apply which algorithm? Bubble sorting algorithm on buffer. Okay, it is expected that you should know this bubble sorting algorithm. I will not explain bubble sorting algorithm to you. So in order to implement bubble sorting algorithm, we require two loop, and you know how to implement loop in assembly language. So in order to implement loop, again there are different approaches which we can follow in assembly language in order to implement the loop. One common approach is that you can store some count in a register. Okay, then you can write code for performing certain operation, and once that operation is performed one time, what you have to do? You have to decrement the count that you have stored in some register, and then by using a conditional jump instruction, you have to check whether that count is zero or not. If count is not zero, then you can repeat that particular operation. So again, you are implementing loop starting from first assignment. So I hope you will be able to write code for this step number 3. So please try to write that code. Okay, in order to write this code, what you must know? You must know what are content of buffer. You must have understood how numbers are getting stored, how numbers are getting stored from file in this buffer. Okay, and then try to write this code. So this is step number 3. Then last step, step number 4. So in step number 4, what you have to do? You have to write content of buffer into 1.txt file. Okay, so after applying sorting, after applying bubble sorting on the buffer, can you tell me what should be the content of buffer? Yes, so sorting, so first number, it will be a 32H, after that 0AH. Please try to understand, I am not going to sort 0AH. So 0AH means it is an enter key. So this 0AH must be at same position before sorting and after sorting. Okay, position of this 0AH character should not get changed. After 0AH, so which will be the next number that will come? 33H. Okay, again I will have 0H, and then I will have next number, that is 36H, and then again I will have 0AH. So this should be the content of buffer after applying sorting. Okay, so now what you have to do, you have to write sorted elements of this buffer into 1.txt file. So in order to do this, what you have to do, you have to use write system call. Again, you are familiar with write system call. What are parameters of write system call? First parameter is function number. What is function number of write operation? Yes, it is 1. Then you will require file handle of the file on which you want to perform write operation. So I want to perform write operation on 1.txt file. So file handle of 1.txt file we are already stored in X. Then third one is buffer. So in write operation, what is going to happen? Content of buffer will be copied into the file. Try to understand read and write operation. In case of a read operation, what we did, we copied content of file into the buffer, and in write operation, what will happen? Reverse thing. Content of buffer will be copied into the file. Okay. Then next parameter will be size of the buffer. So this is about write system call. So this is step number 4. So this write system call will also return one value in RX register. So which is that value? So that value will be a negative value if file write operation is not successful, and if write operation is successful, then RX register will contain a number which will indicate how many characters are transferred from buffer into the file. Okay, so this is about different steps of this bubble sorting program. I hope you can write now program for this particular, you can write code for this particular program. Now I will explain you this file open operation by taking one example. Okay, I will not explain this assignment. Okay, I will not explain code, please try to understand. Just I will explain this file open operation. So I will try to write one simple assembly language program. So we know that in assembly language program, first of all data section is there, then BSS section is there, then we have text section. In text section we take main function, main, okay, and then RET. So here I will write first of all one display function. Okay, so why we have written display function? Yes, we have written display function in order to display the number. Okay, so display procedure is also clear to you. We are discussing display procedure starting from first assignment. So let's assume that this display procedure will display a number which is stored in RET. Okay, so how we write that display procedure? Yes, first of all we take that number which is to be displayed in RX, then we perform rotate left operation on RX 4 times. After that again we copy that rotated number in RX. After that we do AND operation of RX with 0FH. Then we compare EL with 09. If it is less than or equal to, we go to the next. Otherwise here what we have to do, add AL comma 07, and here we add AL comma 30H. After that in AL I will get ASCII value of the character which is to be displayed. So we have to store that ASCII value in some variable. So here I will take one variable, suppose temp. Then here I will store move. Then in temp I will copy content of RX. Now I want to display a content of temp by using write system call. So what is code for write system call? Move rx comma 1. This one indicate that I want to perform write operation. Then move rdi comma 1. Second one indicate that I want to perform write operation on the screen. Then move rsi comma. I want to display temp. Okay. And then move rdx comma. What is size of temp? 8. And then syscall. Okay. So how many digits will be displayed by this code? Only one digit. We want to repeat this procedure how many times? 16 times. So here we have to take one count, suppose R15. So I will decrement that R15 here, and if it is not 0, I will go to the back 1. Okay, so already we discussed this procedure. I will not explain this code. Everybody is familiar with this code. So now let's try to check whether that display procedure is working or not. So in RF register, I will take one number and I will call that display procedure. So which number I have taken in R8? 1234H. So let's check whether we are getting output 1234H. So NASM, there is error at line number 17. So here is line number 17. Yes, what is that error? Yes, instruction is missing. Move R15,16. Okay, NASM, then GCC, then 2C. What is output here? 1234. So this indicates that whatever code I have written is correct. So this is a practice that usually you should follow. Whenever you are writing some code, immediately you should check whether it is working or not. Okay, don't check output of your program after writing whole program. Okay, if you write 500 lines of code and then if you are checking output, then it is very difficult to find the errors present in that program. So always try to develop your program step by step. So display procedure is clear. Now what I want to do, I want to understand file open system call. So for file open system call, I will require file path. So let's assume that I want to open a file. Which file? 1.txt file. Okay, I have created 1.txt file here. Yes, 1.txt file. I want to know its path. So just go in its properties. So here you will get path of that particular file. So I will copy this path. Okay, so file p db. So this is file path, but here name is missing. File name is missing. What is the name of file? 1.txt comma 0. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to open this file. Okay, so I will see how to open this file. So for opening file, we have already seen file open system call. These are four parameters of file open system call. Okay, which is first parameter? Function number. So which is that function number? 2. So this function number, so how we are going to pass these parameters? Yes, how we pass parameters? By using registers. Which registers we use? First register is RX, second register is RDI, third register is RSI, and fourth register is RDX. Okay, so for passing parameters, we have seen that we can use these registers. So can you tell me first instruction? Yes, it will be move. Yes, which is first register? RX. Which is first parameter? First parameter is 2. Then which is second parameter? What this 2 indicate? Yes, please tell me what this 2 indicate. This 2 is a function number of file open system call, right? Then move RDI, second register is RDI. Which is second parameter here? Yes, which is second parameter? File path. So we have copied file path in which variable? File p. Okay, then move. Which is third register? RSI. RSI. So comma RSI comma, which is third parameter of file open system call? Yes, mode in which that file is to be open. So here we are going to use which value? 402H. What this first 4 indicate? We want to open file in append mode. What this 2 indicate? So this 2 indicate that I want to open that file in read and write mode. Okay, and here instead of 0, I can take 4. Okay, so here if I take 4, what is going to happen? Now see what I am trying to do. I am trying to open a file. So here 2 possibilities are there. The file which I am trying to open may not be present in the system. Okay, so if file which we are trying to open is not present in the system, then that file will be created due to this second digit. If I specify this second digit as 4, okay, then what is going to happen? The file which I am trying to open is not present in the system, then that file will be created. And here if I take 0, then what will happen? If the file which I am trying to open is not present, then it will not be created. So this will be considered as an error, okay, due to this 0. So at least this first 4 is clear to you. First 4 indicate that I want to open file in append mode, and this 2 indicate that I want to open file in read write mode. Okay, means read and write operations both are allowed. then move rd x comma, which is next parameter. Next parameter is access permission. So for access permission, I told you that you have to take which value, 7770. Okay, so read write execute permission to all three types of user and then syscall. So this is code for file open system call. So I told you that file open system call will return one value in RX register. So what you have to do, you have to store that value in some variable. So take one variable in BSS section, suppose X, RESQ and one. So in this X, I want to store content of RX. Okay, so what this square bracket indicate? Yes, I hope everybody should be aware about this. So square bracket indicate memory location pointed by X. So RX will be copied in the memory location pointed by X. Okay. Now I want to display value of X. So what I will do, I will copy that X in R8. Okay. And then I will call which procedure? Display procedure. Already we have written this display procedure. Okay. And what that display procedure is doing? That display procedure is displaying the number which is present in R8. Now I want to display X. So what I should do? I should copy that X in R8 and then I should call that display procedure. Now let's see what is the output here. See which value I am getting here. Yes. Which value I am getting here? It is 03. Okay, so 3 means it is positive value, right? So positive, I am getting positive value. What it indicate? It indicate that file is open successfully. Now see, I am changing a name of the file. Instead of 1, suppose I will take 9. Okay, and then let us see what will be the output here. Now see here, I am getting positive value. No, here I am getting negative value. This FFF indicate that I am getting negative value here. Okay, so what this FF indicate? So this is just 2's complement representation of the negative number which is written in RX register by file open operation. We have seen that if file is not open successfully, then else what will be the content of RX register? Negative value. Okay, so which file we are trying to open? Yes, we are trying to open which file? 9.txt. Whether 9.txt file is present in the system, let's check. No, 9.txt is not present. So that's why I am getting negative value as output. Now whether 1.txt file is present? Yes, it is present, 1.txt file. Okay, so if I replace this name with 1.txt, whether I will get negative value? Yes, let's check again. Nazm gcc. So whether I am getting now negative value? No. So I am getting 3. So what is this 3? 3 is a file handle. What is file handle? It is unique number assigned by operating system whenever some file is open or created successfully. Okay, so this is unique number means in a same program, suppose now if I open some another file 2.txt, is it possible that file handle of 2.txt will be 3? No, it will be somewhat, it will be different. It may be either 4. Okay, so this is about file open. Okay, I hope now step number one is clear to you how to open the file. Okay, then let's try to open some file in append mode. Okay, and then we will try to perform write operation on that file. Okay, so let's see it with the help of one example. Suppose 1.txt. So what are content of 1.txt? 3 to 6. Okay, now what we will do? We have opened this file in which mode? Append mode. Yes, this to indicate that I can perform read as well as write operation. So let's try to write something in this file. So if I want to perform write operation, so in order to perform write operation, what we have to do? We have to use write system call. Yes, already we have seen parameters of write system call. So when we perform write operation, then what happens? Content of some buffer will be copied into the file. Okay, so in order to perform write operation, we will require buffer. Okay, so let's take some buffer, suppose m1, then db, then suppose srescoe, then comma 10 comma 0. So can I say that this is buffer? Yes, buffer means what? It is the area of the memory, right? So this m1, assume that this m1 is our buffer. Okay, so I want to copy this m1 in 1.txt file. Okay, see, I'm not explaining you a bubble sorting program. You have to write code for this bubble sorting program. These are the steps. Okay, first step, open a file open system call, then file read system call, then you have to write code for bubble sorting, and then you have to perform write operation. So now what I am going to tell you, I am going to explain you write operation, how we can perform write operation on some file. So now what I am going to do, I am going to write which string, I am going to write which buffer, this m1 buffer in which file, 1.txt file. Okay, now let's try for this. So what will be the first instruction? Move rx comma, which is first parameter. Yes, it is function number of write operation. What is function number of write operation? 1. Then move rdi comma, I want to perform write operation on which file? 1.txt. what is file handle of 1.txt file? Yes, I have stored that file handle in which variable? X. So I will require that file handle. Yes, so I have to copy that file handle in rdi. Now see what I have written. I have written move rdi comma square bracket x. Okay, then move rsi comma, which is third parameter of write system call, content of buffer. Okay, so which is a buffer here? Our buffer is m1. Okay, our buffer is m1, so that's why, yes, that's why move rsi comma m1, and then move rdx comma m1 length. Okay, size of that buffer. So here we have to calculate size of the buffer. So how we can we calculate size of this buffer? Yes, so already we know we will take one name, suppose m1 len, then equ, yes, then dollar dash m1. okay, so in m1 len I will get length of that buffer, and then I will say syscall. Let's see whether this code is working. So see, this is content of my text file. Before performing write operation, it is containing only 3, 2, 6, these numbers. Okay, and now what I am trying to do, I am trying to write this m1 buffer in that 1.txt file. Let's execute this code. So nasm, then gcc and 2. Okay, now let's check content of that file 1.txt. Yes, edit anyway. Okay, so see, initially what was content of that 1.txt file? It there was only 3, okay, 2, 6, and now see here, can you see this string sresCoE? What is this sresCoE? Yes, so this is m1 string. Okay, sresCoE. So this sresCoE, this string has been copied into this particular file. So this is about write system call. I hope now it is clear to you. Now see, again one more point, where I am getting this sresCoE string at the end. Okay, so previous content of 1.txt file is as it is, and the new data which I am trying to copy in this text file is getting appended. Why it is getting appended? Because of this mode. Okay, here I have specified the mode in which that file is to be open. So I have told you that this 4 indicate that I want to open file in append mode, so that whatever write operation I am performing on that file will add new data at the end of that particular file. Okay, and due to this 2, read as well as write operations will be allowed on that file. Okay, instead of this 2, if I use here 0, can I perform write operation on 1.txt file? No. Okay, so this is about write operation. So I hope this assignment is clear to you. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me at any time. Okay, so let's try to write code for this assignment. Thank you.